All right, hi guys, welcome back to Comfort Budgets, a cash stuffing, savings channel where we are working on living comfortably within our budget and being comfortable with abundance because we all deserve it. So welcome or welcome back. I'm super excited to have you here. I'm a very new channel, only have a couple of videos up. So today I wanted to give a quick shout out to some of my very new subscribers. Coffee and Budget, one of my very first subscribers, Liz and Les, Maria's Budgeting, and Golden Girl Budgets. So at this time, those are some of my very first subscribers, and they have all been really kind and welcoming to the community. So hi there. I hope you take a chance to check them out as well. But today what I wanted to do was a video about how I navigate cash stuffing with all prop money. So if you don't know, I use prop money for all of my envelopes. The money I use is a representation of the money that is in my various accounts, and it really helps me to manage just like visually and mentally how much money I am committing to each category. But since I am using prop money, and that means I pretty much exclusively use debit and credit cards when I'm out and about, it requires a little bit of extra time on the back end just to ensure that these envelopes are up to date. And I want to show you how I manage that. I do think cash stuffing this way requires a little bit of extra time, but I do also think that it's a lot of fun. So I'm actually looking at spending money and balancing my budget in a whole new light doing it this way. So let's go ahead and jump into it. Also, all of the items that you see me use today that I can link, I will link below, along with some other money-saving things that I've found throughout my short journey here. So if you love cash stuffing, want a welcoming community, or just, you know, want a space where you can safely connect and learn about budgeting tips and tricks, please go ahead and subscribe. In order to keep everything super organized, I have to track my spending on one of these. This is the Expense Tracker by The Budget Mom. I purchased her most recent discounted digital planner, and it's really nice because you can use it over and over again. But I went ahead and didn't go through these envelopes for a couple of days so that way I could show you what it looks like. So today we're going to be looking at two categories. We're going to be looking at my regular bank account where most of my expenses come out of, and then we're also going to be looking at one of my credit cards, and I'm going to show you guys how I manage debit card and credit card purchases today. So let's go ahead and get started. For this particular section, one thing that I really like, because I love writing with pens, I love these pens. These are the Frixon erasable pilot pens. These are great because if you make a mistake, which you might be able to see as I have, you can just erase it and start over. So, okay, let's jump into it. So the first thing I do when I'm writing down my expenses, one, I write the date. You'll see some dates are incomplete, and that's because they're pending charges, but I know I spent this money. I know they will be confirmed, so I wrote them down here. Then I write where the money went to or what it was used for, and then I write the category. Now you can see all of these have a category except for one, and I'm gonna show you guys how I manage that. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're just gonna jump into it. So the first thing I have is $6.54. My boyfriend and I went to AMC the other day to watch Smile. Are you guys horror movie fans? Because we really are, and that movie was so good. Like, honestly, I give it a 10 out of 10. But, okay, so you can see I have $6.54 here that I spent. That was on one drink, because y'all know the movies be expensive. And that was a date, basically, that him and I went on. So I'm going to take that out of our date envelope. Okay, so you can see here that I have a date night envelope. So I don't deal with change because it's prop money and I don't want to deal with prop change. And because my goal is to focus on saving, I round up. So this is $6.54, which means it's actually going to be $7. And all that change that I'm saving, all that change that's left over, it's actually just like creating a buffer in my account. Okay, so first thing we have to do is $20 is not going to easily break up, but because I have prop money, I'm actually going to cash this or exchange this for a 10, a 5, and 5 ones. So give me 1 second while I do that. Okay, so now we can see that instead of a 20, we have 10, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And I need to take out $7. So I'm going to take out the 5, 6, 7. So now that means date night has 10, 11, 12, 13. It has $13 in here. So I'll put the money back in here. And then I will go ahead and track on my little tracker here that on 10, honestly, we went to the movies yesterday. So 23, I went to AMC and I spent $7. So now I have 13. All right, and now it's tracked. So when all of this is updated here, I will come back here to my sheet and I will highlight this amount. So once I highlight a section, that means that the amount that is here is also reflected in my cash envelope. Like, my cash envelopes have been updated, which is really helpful. Okay, so I'm just gonna continue to take you guys through this, but we are going to do our Peloton charge last, because I want to show you what I do, because I did not budget for this, so I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. I forgot, because we're learning a lot. So the next thing is our Netflix subscription, and we see that's $19.99. So I'm going to go to my subscription folder, and hopefully I have a 20 in here. Wow, I do. So I'm going to go ahead and take out this 20. I'm gonna put it over here, and now I have 50, 70, 90, 110, 130, 131. Put that back in there, and then we'll just continue to go down. Okay, so I don't remember what day that came out, but I know it's for Netflix, and it is $20. So we have 131 left in subscriptions. And then we'll just come back here, like I said, highlight Netflix. Great. Okay, so next we have an insurance charge. And that is for my dog's insurance. So we're gonna go to insurance kids. If you guys are wondering why it says insurance kids, it's because of the labels I got from Amazon. Didn't just have a regular insurance thing. So anyways, I mean, my dog is kind of like my kid, so. So for this one, it is $31.25. So once again, I'm gonna have to make change. So I'm gonna take one of these 50s and go ahead and exchange it for a couple of better bills for this exchange. All right, guys, so we exchanged a 50 for 50 in smaller bills. So let's see, now we have 20, 30, 40, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. Perfect. So we can go ahead add this into the mix. And like I said, our insurance for the dog insurance was $31.25, which means I'm going to take out $32. Okay. Yeah, okay. So 20, 31, 2. Perfect. Took out $32. And then we have 50, 70, 80, 85, 86, 87, 88, $89 left. $89 left in insurance. And here we go. Okay, we've updated that. We can highlight it. Now we're gonna go to our joint bills. So this one's really easy. This is what I contribute outside of the mortgage to the monthly bills. And this one, just so you guys know, this one's unique because you can see it says transfer. This is me just transferring that amount into our joint account. So I already did that transfer. So I'm gonna go ahead, take out this, which should be $80 exactly, 50, 70, 80. That's correct. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and register that as a transfer. So now that's zero. Now that'll be really common of folders like this, like joint bills, because even though like I'm not keeping an eye on exactly when the $80 is getting pulled or whatever, because that's what I need to contribute each month and I know that it'll help cover our bills for the month, I just transfer it and then it's not money that I spend anymore. So that's why this account will continuously go from 80 to zero back and forth. And if anything is like really confusing or you're like, what the heck? Just let me know because I want to explain as much as I can. Okay guys, so the next transfer is for our home binder. So this one is a little unique and I want to explain why. So after I get paid, I will then go into all of the binders that I have and, you know, see if anything needs to be transferred. Now, for the most part, all of my budgets and everything, all of my envelopes sit in my account, but because I do share the expenses with my partner, him and I have joint accounts. And so with home maintenance, it's really more of a to-do task with this. I have transferred the money and it is sitting in our joint account, but I'm not gonna take the money out of here yet because I haven't actually spent it on anything. So this is gonna continue to be a sinking fund and I will have this money here. So if something comes up, we have to call the plumber or an electrician, knock on wood that we don't. But if we do, I have the money sitting here and I know how much money is here. But I also have like a little to do on my account. Like I need to transfer that money into our joint account so it's ready when we're ready to use it. So I hope that is helpful. Now we're gonna go into our credit card accounts. Now, these two are also unique and I want to show you how I use them and why they are unique. Oh, I forgot to mention. So since I've already transferred this money and explained why it's staying in the account that it's staying in, I am gonna highlight it because that to do is to done. You know what I mean? Okay. Okay, so the next two expenses on here are credit card expenses, but I want to save those until until we get into a credit card expense, because then I think it'll make more sense. So we're gonna save these two just for a moment. We'll handle them here in this video today, but we're just gonna save them for a second, and we're actually gonna go into our next regular expense, which was at Walgreens today. So I went to Walgreens and bought some bottled water. I was very much hankering for a huge thing of ice cold bottled water, our ice machine. I'm trying to clean it really good right now. I have a Nugget ice maker, you guys. It is glorious, but it literally needs to be cleaned all the time. We have hard water. It's just like such a hassle. So while it is being, you know, just the upkeep, we're waiting for the upkeep. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go get an ice cold water. Why were the fridges out at Walgreens? I've never seen that in my whole life. So I just bought the bottles, brought them home, and then put them in the fridge. Okay, so I bought two bottles of water. They were $5. Gonna take this out of personal. I suppose I could take it out of food, but it's personal. I guess, I don't know. It just feels like that makes sense, just randomly wanting food, or wanting two bottles of water. So I have a $5 in here, which is glorious. We're gonna put that money to the side. And there's a reason I'm having all this money to the side, and I'll show you that in a second. So now we have $150 left in personal, plus that $5 Target gift card, which I'm coming for. I am coming for you. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead, and I went to Walgreens today. So we're gonna go ahead and update our tracker to show that we have now $150. And then you know the drill, highlight it to show that it's checked off. Now our next category, one of my favorite categories, income. I love an income category. So my brother sent me some money. He sent me $18.90 for something, and I'm gonna show you guys how I manage this. Since I have prop money, of course I can just go pull $18, and I like to have an envelope that I keep track of extra money I wasn't expecting until I decide to cash stuff. So of course, it's in my blue binder because this is my favorite binder. And of course, a category called income would be in here. So I actually have already put the money in here because as soon as he sent me it like a few days ago, I was like, I need to track this. So basically what I did is I went into my prop money drawer and I grabbed $18. So we have 10, 15, 16, 17, 18. So this $18, I don't know what I'm gonna do with this $18 yet, you know? Like, I'm not sure if I'm gonna put it towards, you know, one of my sinking funds, or if I'm gonna put it towards one of my bills, or just give it to myself to spend. It's up to me at this point, but right now, I don't really wanna stuff $18 just yet. I wanna wait till I have a little bit more to stuff. So I'm just gonna leave it back here, and it's just gonna kind of be like pending money. It doesn't have a home, it doesn't have a job just yet. So this envelope is for money that doesn't have a job just yet, but I track it just like I track all of my other expenses. We can see right here that I tracked that on Friday, my brother sent me $18, and he sent it via Venmo. Now we're gonna go into how I manage credit card expenses, because credit cards is really two to-dos, right? You need to, of course, you know, swipe your card, and then you may need to make sure that you have the money allocated to pay for the different items. And that's where cash stuffing is super helpful. But then you also have to make sure that you pay off the credit card. So I'm gonna show you guys how I do this. It keeps things extremely simple for me. I do think this is the one piece of the pie where you're gonna probably have to pull from more than one binder, and I'll show you why. Okay, so for our first expense, we went to Texas Roadhouse on Friday or Saturday, I don't remember. And I bought food. It was very good and I just finished it for lunch today because you get so much food, and they have the best bread, but that's neither here nor there. So you can see that I spent $68.74 on food, so on my credit card. So how do I manage that? Well, first I need to grab my bill binder because that's where my credit card binders are in. So you can see here, I have my Apple credit card binder right here. Now, I swiped my card for $68.74. We know I round up, so that means I need $69 to go in this folder to cover this amount. Now, I swiped my card for my food. So I'm gonna go into my favorite binder, this blue one, into my food binder, and I'm going to take out $69. So here we are, we have our food binder. Let's see if we have enough change. Looks like we don't, no big deal. Give me a quick second. I'm gonna make change out of this 20. Gosh, another reason why I love prop money, it's just so easy to make change. Okay, so I have 10, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So I went ahead and exchanged that for smaller bills. Gonna get this organized now. And now I need to take out my $69. So 50, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. Okay, so let's take a look. Just to make sure I counted it right, did it right. Because you never know, especially with prop money. Just like an FYI, you gotta be careful because it can be really slick. So we have 50, 60, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. Okay, that is correct. So we have $69. And that means we have 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105. 105 left over. Ooh, why when I was counting that, I was thinking about 106 in Park. Y'all remember that on BET? Okay, so we have 105 left over. So very easy, just the same thing we've done many a time here. We're gonna go ahead, track our spending. So that was Texas Roadhouse. And we spent $69, which means we have 105 left. So this is updated, but we spent the money on our Apple Card. So what do? We come to our Apple Card folder and we're gonna go ahead and add the money directly into here. So we're gonna add this $69 into our Apple Card payment because we know that we're only swiping our card for things that we have the money for, which means that every time we swipe our card, we can probably pull the money we need from a folder or an envelope rather, and pay it. So I've added the $69. So in a few days when it's time for me to pay my bill, because I just, like, before my bill's due, I come in here, count up my money and pay it. I know how much money I need to pay because I can count this up and know what needs to be paid. So now in my Apple Card, I have 50, 100, 150, 170, 180, 190, 200, 205, 210, 215, 220, 225, 226, 227, 228, 229, 230, 231, 232, 233, 234, 234. Okay, so we have 234. My envelope has 234. Putting the money in here. It's getting thick. Oof. All right, zipping it up. And now, just coming on over to Texas Roadhouse on my Apple Card sheet and highlighting it. And that's how I handle credit card expenses. So let's do a couple more so I can kind of take you through those. All right, guys, so sorry about any changes in the view or anything. My camera died, so I had to adjust that and then come back really quick. So we're back and we're going to work on our next credit card payment, and that is for YouTube. It's our subscription payment for $17.43. So we are gonna go ahead and we're gonna open this guy up here. And we're just going to go to subscriptions. And we know it's $17.43. I always round up, which means we need $18. Let's see if we have the change. Okay, we don't. The theme of today. So I'm gonna go make change out of this 20 and I'll be right back. All right, so we went ahead and exchanged for smaller bills. So we've got $20 here. So now I just need to go in here and get $18. So we've got 10, 15, 16, 17, 18. So just to confirm, we've got 10, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, that goes into our pile right there. And then what we have left is 50, 70, 90, 110, 111, 112, 113. 113 left in subscriptions. All right. We'll grab our erasable pen. And that payment was for our YouTube subscription. $18 and 113 left. All right, so, and we have 113 left, but this is a credit card payment, so we're not done. We're gonna go to our Apple Card. And we are going to add this in here. Is getting really thick, so I'm gonna do a bill exchange at the end, at the very end for this if you want to stay. 50, 100, 150, 170, 180, 190, 200, 210, 215, 220, 225, 230, 235, 240, 241, 242, 243, 244, 245, 246, 247, 248, 249, 250, 251, 252. 252. Okay. Did I already say that? Y'all, that's too many bills. That's too many bills. That's why we gotta be careful. Okay, so once again, this was for our YouTube and it was $18. So now we have 252. Now, I know you're probably like, Brittany, you're just going back and forth in this. Normally, when I'm not filming, I will just tally up all the Apple Card. Like, I'll do all the Apple Card payments and just put it in once. But I want to be, like, very clear and show you guys each process, like, very clearly. So that's why I'm doing it this way. All right. And then finally, we have $7 to Dunkin'. I went this morning and got their... I got a peanut butter cup. Well, I got a peanut butter cup latte or macchiato, I think. It was a little sad this morning. I'm not gonna lie, it just kind of tastes like sweet latte drinks, which I love. But I need to put a little more money on my Dunkin' card to get it, and I got an iced tea for my boyfriend. So I ended up putting $7, which is why we have a $7 payment here. My Apple Card's just already set up. So I'm deciding that's gonna come out of food. I know you're probably like, shouldn't it come out of coffee? I mean, it could, I don't know. This is where my heart is sending me. So we need, $7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, only $5. Okay, I need to make change for this 100. What else is new? Give me 1 second. All right, so I exchanged some money out of our money pile for 100. I made change, so now we've got $100 here. You can see we've got 50, 70, 80, 90, 95, 100. So now we can pay our dues for the $7. This hurts, y'all. I don't know. There's something about, even though it's fake money, I'm like, oh, I used to have so much in food and now I only have like less than 100 and I just got paid. So it's like one of those things where I'm like, okay, you have to be a little more careful with your money. And I think that's like the most beneficial part of budgeting this way. Okay, so now I need, like I said, to take $7 out. 5, 6, 7. So we've taken out 5, 6, and 7, which means we're gonna have $98 left. Oh, I forgot to count it. I like the counting. That's my favorite part when I'm watching them, so I don't wanna forget. Okay, guys. So we now have 50, 70, 80, 90, 95, 96, 97, 98. The math is mathing. Okay. So we've got $98 in there for food. And we went there today. That was for Dunkin'. It was minus 7. So now we have 90. Okay, great. As usual, we aren't done yet. We're going on over here to our, you guessed it, Apple Card. And we're gonna go ahead and add $7 in here. And I know you guys are probably tired of seeing me count the same amount of money. So we will save the counting until the end where I exchange it. But we know we just added $7. So this should be, we're adding Dunkin' plus 7. So it should be at 259 right now, which is great. All right, and then we just come over to our sheet, highlight it to show that we've taken care of that expense. So we love to see it. Now, the final thing I want to show you guys is what I do when I take care of my actual credit card payments. So on here, you can see it is time to pay two of my credit cards. It's time to pay my Chase card and it's time to pay my Care credit card. Now, when we go to Chase, I will log into my bank account and then I'll come over to my Chase binder. And then I will look and I will see how much money have I allocated to Chase. It's $600. And we can confirm this. So we have 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 550, 570, 590, 595, 600. So then before I got on camera with you guys, I did this and I made a $600 payment. So I'm gonna take all this money out and put it to the side because that money's gone. It went to pay my bill. And then I'm gonna minus 600. And so when I go here the next couple of weeks when it's time to make my minimum payment, because I am working on paying down debt, I will be able to see, okay, I don't have any money in Chase, so I need to stuff the minimum payment and all of that. So that's how that works for credit card payments. And then I just highlight it, know how much I paid, that's how much that's gone. And then this also represents like
$600 is gone out of my bank account and I can account for it, if that makes sense. And then we're gonna go to care credit. Now I'm really excited about care credit because I already made my personal minimum payment. So I pay over the minimum, but I really wanna pay this off next month. And we are in great shape to do that because this is all extra money. So I already made a payment. You can see I paid off $200. And then I added a $133 to this, so we have a payment of $175. So this is an extra payment for the month. Same thing. I went into care credit. Same system though. I went into care credit this morning, came to this page, counted this money, made the $175 payment, and then we're emptying the binder because there's no more money. Like if I had to make another payment to care credit tomorrow, I would be like, oh, I have to take the money from somewhere because it's empty. So we're gonna go ahead, track that we made an extra payment. So excited to retire this folder. and it was $175 and now we have zero in this account. Okay, all right. So that is how I handle credit card bills. Okay, so it's like a really nice flow with credit cards. Like the money comes out of my credit card, it is reserved into one of my credit card binders until it's time to pay, and then I pull it out just like it comes out of my bank account. I hope that is making sense, but if it's not, just let me know. Okay, so the only other thing that we have to deal with here is our Peloton subscription. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I forgot about this bill. So it is highlighted pink because truly I was like, where should I put this? Technically, Peloton is a monthly subscription, so it should be included in my subscriptions, but it was $44. The reason I forgot is because my job had this really cool benefit where I got the subscription for free for 3 months, and that 3 months went fast. So you can see I need to allocate $44 to this. Now, I could just go directly into my subscription because I know I have money to cover it. But I'm like trying to decide what the best way to do it is because my subscriptions will not be able to cover the rest of the month because I haven't allocated for it. So this is why it's really important to me that I have created two like fail safes for my binders. So what that means, they're basically buffers. The first one is miscellaneous. This one gets $15. It has gotten $15 the last couple of paychecks I've gotten. So the $15 here is for if anything goes over. So that's great and something I have obviously needed. But then I created this additional one. It's called, this binder, it has more money. It has $30 in it, but it also is supposed to cover anything that just like pops up unexpected. So what I'm gonna show you guys is today I am going to go ahead and pay my Peloton subscription out of my subscriptions because that's how I have categorized like this category. But I am going to highlight it pink on this page because when it gets to be a little later in the month and a subscription comes up and my binder is short, I can go back here and recognize that it is short. This is also kind of signifying me if I get extra money, like the $18 my brother gave me, I need to put it in my subscriptions folder because it's going to be running short. Additionally, I can pull, once I get short on those other categories, I will pull from my miscellaneous and my OSHU category to cover this expense. And that's why it's kind of like a very minimal version of the emergency folder or whatnot. It's really nice to have buffers like this because it just makes sure that once things happen, which they do, you don't have to feel bad about them or negative about them or anything like that. Like, things will happen. I wish we could control everything, but we can't. So when those things happen, just remember that's 100% okay. Just be prepared by building in some of these systems. Now, of course, let's say, well, something happened and you didn't have a system set up yet. That's okay. Like, you don't know what you don't know. So in that case, I would just pull from one of my more frivolous binders. You know, this money could come from date night, it could come from beauty, it could come from any non-essential binder because the money has already been spent and so I need to cover that expense. But then next month, let's say, I can reevaluate and say, do I really use my Peloton? Is it a subscription that I want to keep? And if so, add it into my budget. But if not, I can reevaluate and move money around so that it's covered. So that's what you have to know when it comes to this stuff. It's A-okay, things will happen, but just be prepared and kind of have a system to deal with these things. Okay, so what that means is, like I said, I'm gonna go into my subscriptions envelope. And we are going to pull out $40, $44. For Peloton. I'm not gonna lie, I hurt my feelings when I saw this. Oh, this cost. I was like, wait a minute, what? Okay, so we're subtracting $44. So, 20, 40, 1, 2, 3. You gotta be kidding me, y'all. Oh my gosh, do you see that? I'm $1 freaking short. I gotta make change. This is getting out of control. Okay guys, for the 40th time this video, so sorry, I made change. I'm gonna take one more dollar out of there. Okay, so we took $44 out. Let's just confirm that we have $44 here. Okay. 20, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, $44 there. So left we have 50, 60, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. We have $69 left in subscriptions. Okay, so one thing I'm also going to do just to flag it for myself is I'm going to highlight this in pink just to show myself there's an unexpected expense here. So, you know, I need a lot of fail safes built in for me because I forget things. So that's it. Now I can look at my expenses. Oh, sorry. So now I can look at my expenses and they're all highlighted. So I know I've taken care of all of them for the week or whatever. Now, typically I do this every couple of days, so it's not a lot. I'm also not filming, so it goes much quicker. I just really wanted to give you guys like an in-depth version of how I manage with prop money. But the one thing that I've found that has been really, really helpful for me is actually counting up how much money I spent. Now, I know this might seem, I'm just gonna get this organized, but I know this might seem a little bit odd, but the reason why I like this is because I've really started leaning into the mantra that money goes quickly, but it also comes very quickly. And because money comes so quickly, I don't have to be anxious when I spend a lot of money. If anything, I can be grateful that I have the money to spend, and I know whenever I spend money, it'll come right back to me. So, quickly, frequently, all that stuff. So that's why at the end of these, I like to do, even when I'm not filming, obviously, I do a little count up. And then I thank the universe for having this much money in my life that I could pay. So I'm gonna go ahead and count out our official expenses, how much money we spent today. Okay, So 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 750, 770, 790, 810, 830, 850, 870, 890, 910. Okay, so 963 is how much we spent today, and we were able to do so many wonderful things because we had, because we planned for it, and we are grateful, and we were able to use our money and use it as a tool. Money is a tool, and I hope you can continue to find peace in the fact that it is a tool that comes to you frequently and that can be used for the betterment of yourself and of your family and your financial goals. So thank you guys so much for joining. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and subscribe and like and comment. If you have any questions at all about why I use prop money, how I use prop money, XYZ, anything that came up today, please drop them below. I promise to respond to every single comment. And yes, I will see you in the next one. Bye.